Why, hello there, everybody. Welcome back to the adventures of Emperor Rex, the 54-year-old kick-ass dude. Last time we won Alania in a holy war, we have a giant threat of a 30,000-man landless adventurer army in England. But first, we have some bookkeeping to do, and we gained all this territory in the Kingdom of Alania. Well, obviously not those. So let's hand some out, because we are way over our personal limits. Let's just go find some vassals, because we're already over our vassal limit, too, so we want to give it to people who already work for us. Preferably family members. To you, my good sir, I grant you... Let's get in a little more so we can see it. You look like a man, so how about I give you a manly territory? I don't think he's a man. I think he's a man. He didn't marry a relative. That's approved of. Maybe not by the rest of the Empire, but definitely by me. As you saw in one of the previous episodes, when I looked at how many inbred people there were in the Empire, I think there were too many. Too many people be marrying inside the family tree. Just because your cousin's cute don't mean you gotta put your dick in her. County of Kuban, we'll give him to this dude. Making people love the Emperor. He's already super popular. None of his vassals dislike him. And considering how big the damn Empire is, that says a hell of a lot. I'm trying to find some relatives. I thought we gave you one earlier. Maybe not. Maybe it was the dude who had a similar beard. It's a pretty popular beard style. I'll give you the county of Kuma. Skuma? No, you drug addict. Well, you're not really blood, but you look cool too. I will grant you... Oh, I should just give these to people who are blood, but there's so many to deal with. Maybe this is one of the few times where it'd be actually worth having our holy man hand them out. I just don't know who we'd give them to. Alright, the rest we're going to all give to family members. Nepotism is the way to go. This is a pretty good kingdom we got. You can see 14 out of 16, we're still over. Some of that is cities, though. So when we give it to, like this guy, Pressure, when we give him a county, it'll take multiple of those. So we'll give you a landed title. County of Ugorlik. I bet Ugor enjoys that. And there's one more to give? Is it this one? No. Don't give my territory away. Are you a leprechaun, bro? Hilarious. I'm not a leprechaun. Oh, I'm gonna get your pot of gold. Yeah, we'll give one to this guy. He loves us already, but trying to keep it in the family. Not in the sex way that a lot of them have. Alright, we will give you Sarpa. That should be the last one. Yep, that gets us to 7 out of 6. Let us fly over to England. Wait, no, actually, before we do that, we have one other thing to deal with. We want a new heir. We've wanted that for episodes. Right now, the heir apparent is Prince Stupid, who has no diplomacy. That is not going to do well when people are like, Emperor, I think I'm going to poop on your face. No, Emperor! When we have a stupid guy who's not good at diplomacy. So we've been trying to pop out babies, but these people be whores. So we're going to get rid of some of the older ones. Naveena, we're going to set you aside. Can I imprison you? Oh, people would not like that. We're going to set you aside, girl. Don't need you no more. You're 32. We're going to set you aside. You did not get us any what we needed, girls. Is there a fertile trait? Lustful? Let's get lustful. Let's go after somebody who's lustful. Because lustful people are more likely to have kids. This lady is a leper and a lunatic? They're gonna get married. Or not married. Be my concubine. Oh, no. He would have too. He's a lunatic. He would have been like, finally, someone who understands me. Ooh, a lustful 16-year-old who is patient, charitable, shy. He's shy. Just kind. He's kind. Yes. Oh, no, that's his relative. Never mind. What about this lady? Wait, that's the leper. That's twice now. I'm like, yeah. I'm gonna do it, her vagina will fall off, but that's hot. There's this lady in prison we could take. Ooh, yeah, we just conquered your territory and your husband died. But you're lustful, right? Yeah, new concubine. Can't say no. And let's get another one. It's not worked out getting these genius ones. Let's see if we can get somebody who's got a good trait, though. So we're going to look at geniuses. Violetta in Ireland? Yeah, what about a good Irish girl? Let's see if we can take her as a concubine. Yes! Alright, so we got a girl who's lustful. Hopefully that'll increase the chances of her popping out a baby. It might just increase the chances of her cheating like everybody else. I don't think we got the second one yet. Oh yeah, we gotta wait for her liege to be like, yes, I approve. The first one we didn't worry about a liege because she was in prison. As dark as it is, maybe that's a reason to leave girls in prison, because you can take them as concubines when they become adults. That's very dark. Anyone else want to get ransomed? Oh, there's somebody. Alright, we got our two new concubines. Violetta from Ireland. She's Bulgarian too. She's a genius. She's gregarious, content, a little deceitful and arbitrary. That's not all great, but some of them are awesome. Then we got the lustful Anatolia. They're both like in their 20s. She's trusting and temperate. Ambitious and just trying to pop out some babies. Now, let's move these guys all into Northampton. We're gonna lose some battles up in here. It's not. Oh, you know what we're gonna do? Go home. Let's see if they keep marching north. In fact, if anything, this army, march farther north, see if you can lure them to the north. If we can lure them away from everyone else, we can send these troops in to attack here. Alright, we're gonna merge these guys. Excellent! They might get back in time. We gotta make sure we have really good leaders here. We want the best of the best. Give me a dozen of them and make sure they're dirty! They're gonna be out of there on the 19th? We will not be there in time. They made a mistake and they separated their armies, trying to chase us down. Will you be out in the time, the 26th? Oh, we're not going to be in there in time. That sucks balls. Oh, we got to educate some child. There you go. You're educated. Lady, you can rot. I do not have time to deal with your issues about being in prison. Okay, how big of a river is there between these areas? Wait, there's none between... Wait, what are we in? We're in Warwick. Warwick Davis. Willow. There's not one between there. I thought there was. Let's attack. I don't think they can escape this because we're so close. Nope. This is the army here. The landless adventurer. And we outnumber them greatly. They're going to try and bring reinforcements in. That might be beneficial for us. We might still lose, but... Alright, y'all. These are the only reinforcements we really have around here. There were some troops that I told to go home. Were they the York troops? Yes. Alright. It's crazy. We have enough Tengri troops in England to make a fight for England. When are they going to be in there? The 23rd of March? They might have us outnumbered then. That is worrisome. Come on, keep flanking them. Oh, yeah. That is huge the way we damage their center. Fortunately, they've got a bunch of reinforcements in. Let's educate some stupid grandkids. Who the hell are you? Oh, your grandson too. Hopefully some of these new concubines start turning out babies at some point. We're outnumbered now, unfortunately. We do have a better leader in the center, a better leader on our right, and a better leader on our left than they do. Outnumbered, but with better leaders. We need some reinforcements in there. I don't know if they're going to get there in time. It doesn't seem likely. That center is getting weak. Can we break their center before ours goes? Oh, there's a starting to fall. Yes, and their right flank. Brilliant military tactical genius. And this guy hates us, Abdul. He's like our Muslim dude. And High Chief Sermon, he also broke a flank. High Chief Sermon of Holland. Most excellent. Get the fuck off my land, bitch. This is Tengri land. You didn't want nothing, you shouldn't have started nothing. You can see war score is 6% in our favor right here. That's going to go up dramatically once this battle is done. Because we just trounced him. Boom! It went up to 81%. Let's merge these guys. Where are they going? We're going to chase them down. They're going to Gloucester. I have noticed, as Emperor Rex, that Cosmo and Tiberius, my son and my nephew, are not on the best of terms. A situation I hope to remedy! Family game night! Some people play games like Risk for fun. He can play Risk for real with the entire nation. They had a great time together. 90% war score. Kicking the crap out of them. Look at them run like cowards. I thought you'd come to take England from me, friend. I thought you were going to liberate England for you. Everyone knows England was meant to be a part of the Tengri Empire. When everyone thinks of England, you think of Great Carpathia. Yeah, at least these guys are trying still. They're like, we're still sieging. Prepare to go to hell. Yep, flanks crushed, army crushed, 100%. Sir, there's a rumor that Sophia, one of your nobles, might be corrupt. Yeah, use it as you see fit. Oh, no, wait! Oh, crap, that's how the last spymaster died. We're going to tell all the troops to go home. And you, sir. You dirty, dirty poophead. We're going to end the war. We're going to put you in prison. And then we're going to execute you. Everyone's going to be mad if we execute him? Fuck you, game! Executing Gilhemheim, whatever, using this option is viewed as tyrannical and will lower all your vassals' opinion of you by 10? Why? He's not a part of our empire. He's not a relative of us. He is a foreigner who came and attacked us. Why in the world would our vassals give a shit if we executed a foreigner who attacked us? Shaman Slavic Vrila decided not to risk upsetting his vassals. Isn't that the guy who murdered the last spy master? You're a better spy master. Good job, bro. I can't believe we can't assassinate that guy. Why in the world would the people of Carpathia be like, oh, he brought 30,000 men and tried to destroy us, but don't kill him. Mayor Bozidar, my co-conspirator, tells me that a man is now on the inside of the prison. Oh, I forgot. We were trying to assassinate him before he had his army, Prince Gilheim, the guy I wanted to assassinate. And look, all these people want him dead. So my co-conspirator, Bozidar, the mayor, is like, don't worry, Emperor. Everyone's going to be mad if you do it in front of everyone. I got a guy in the prison. We're going to arrange an escape attempt, you know? And he's sadly going to have a tragic and fatal accident. Excellent. I don't even care if people know. I want that guy dead. And concubines, spread your legs and start shooting out them babies. Prince Stupid is like, dur 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 dur. Alright, any moment now. Success! Prince Gilheim, or is it Gilheim? I don't know, whatever. Was killed while trying to escape prison. No fingers will be pointing my way. Sentence commuted! Excellent. He is dead. Oh, speaking of which. Hey, France, you seem to be at peace. So France is this little territory here. Wales, basically, this little territory here, and this territory in, Italy. But, oh, why can't we usurp his crown? Is he still at war? I swear the son of a bitch fights wars on purpose so we can't usurp his crown, because we can't usurp it while he's at war. Defending against King Assur of Andalusia in the Holy War for Aragon. Aw, come on, man. I just wanted to usurp the French crown. What would we need for the Aquitaine crown? Oh, we'd have to create it, and we don't own enough. Things are going pretty well. We got a couple rebellions left. I don't even know which rebellions are ours. So we gotta find one with a horse on it. That's like some sort of leaf. I could just look at what they're fighting for, but we got time to look around. Oh, that's the other one. This is the Catholic uprising here that I don't know why they're still around. We could probably raise an army and just crush it. You got 1,000 guys? 4,000. Alright, once your army's morale is up, just go crush that Catholic uprising. Rex, you're 55. You don't have a lot more years left to pump out a new kid. Otherwise, Prince Stupid, who has no diplomacy, it is. And without diplomacy, we're going to have a problem with vassal limits. I would hate to think we're going to have civil wars. We're not going to have civil wars, right? There's always a peaceful transition of power. Nobody would be mad at the stupid new emperor. All right, send your army in there. Crush the Catholics. Who dare stand up against us? This is Tangri Town! Interesting enough, though, the leader of our army is Abdul, our Muslim dude. Yep, they had no right flank for some reason. There goes their left flank, there goes their center. Victory! It was. That army had been sitting there forever doing nothing. Alright, we have defeated the Catholic uprising, the seventh one. You can go free, dude. I'm just gonna banish you from the realm. We get it, you're just trying to defend your religion. See, the Emperor's kind. He's like, I get it, I'm a religious man too. But I can't have you around. And then where the hell is the other one? Let's see, it is four? I pronounced it perfectly, thank you. That's not the right one. Oh yeah, there it is. There's got to be a king around here that's got some troops, right? I didn't mean to do that. King of Lithuania, you got enough troops, right? Okay, we're going to send them down there to destroy them. Y'all can go home. Come on, march down there, destroy these dirty rebels. What are these guys the rebels of, anyway? I guess we have to wait till autosave is done. I gotta admit, though, Emperor Rex has been one of the greatest emperors the Empire has ever had. I mean, he ranks with the Dongersons. Like, I think it was the second Dongerson, the scholar, who was one of the great reformers. I mean, Rex has destroyed the Holy Roman Empire. Don't get me wrong, he inherited a better situation than some of his predecessors. But look at that, we own almost all of France now. We took even more of Central Europe. We took Alania. The Empire's grown and grown. We have medium crown authority again. I do worry that his stupid son could fuck some stuff up. I hope not. Let's get these guys in here. What are these? Oh, they're just peasants. We're actually losing that war because they're properly sieging territory. That's right, the King of Lithuania will bring his army down there and teach y'all a lesson very quickly. Y'all shouldn't have been fucking with us. Speaking of fucking with, though, those concubines should start fucking with the Emperor. I swear, they'll fuck everyone but the Emperor. We've had like 3 or 4 concubines have kids with other people. Oh, I think the wife died of the Emperor. Yeah, let's kill these rebels off. Victory! Boom! What's left? Alright, we're gonna chase them down. Get him! Alright, so Emperor, your wife died of illness. That's a shame. We're gonna pick a new ambition, which is to get married. Let us find you a wife. She's sympathetic to Christians. I don't think that's gonna work with a zealous husband. How about a hot wife? How about a wife who's very good at stewardship? Maybe we'll get that. Why are none of those options any good? There we go. She's 39, though. How about somebody... This girl's 17. She's angry and ambitious. She's got a really good stewardship. Yeah, why not? I feel bad for her marrying a guy who's like 3 times her age, but... Oh, and some child needs to be educated. All these grandkids do. Emperor Rex has gotten married again. Are these guys going to actually get away? I'm going to be so pissed. No. I'm going to be so pissed off if those rebels get away. All right, we have destroyed the peasant rebels. Put him in prison. Can we execute you? Yeah. Nobody cares if we execute you because you're a peasant. Such is life, I guess. Tell this army to go home. Truce is expiring with the King of France. He's in the middle of a war, so he still can't usurp his crown. I could have sworn there was one more thing I wanted to do, but I guess I don't remember what it was, so it doesn't matter. We've got a new young wife, 17. We've got some new young concubines. Hopefully he'll have a kid. I don't know how long he's going to live. He's 55. His dad only lived to 55. How long did his granddad live, though? I think his granddad lived to be 66. Let's hope he still lives another 10 to 20 years. I'll see y'all next time. Thanks for hanging out, everybody.